In a rural village in Ethiopia, an 8-year-old boy struggles with life as an orphan and an outcast. He suffers from severe scoliosis, has a heart murmur, is deaf in one ear, and has a deformed right hand. If his scoliosis goes untreated, his body will eventually cave in on itself, crushing his lungs, depriving him of air, and in the end, killing him. So an organization called Mending Kids International arranges for Berhanu to travel to California for life-saving surgery.
Mending Kids International brings children in from outside of the U.S. for surgeries that they just can't get at home. We really feel like what we can do is give them an opportunity to have a surgery that will transform their life, that will restore them back to the childhood that they deserve.
Dr. David Skaggs, chief of the Children's Orthopaedic Center, has assisted Mending Kids on several occasions.
Children's Hospital Los Angeles has the technology and the know-how to change these children's lives. But Mending Kids International, they get the children who need us the most, and they bring them back and allow their lives to be changed.
Mending Kids appoints a host family for Berhanu. Jim and Caroline Nicol, natives of Scotland, will care for Berhanu like he is one of their own while he undergoes multiple operations.
I was expecting maybe like the size of a 7-year-old. He was so tiny and just looked so frightened and, you know, scared.
When he arrived, number one, he was malnourished. So we've had to do everything that we can to try and put some meat on the bone and try and put some weight on. Number two, can't speak a word of English. We're Scottish, we can't speak a word of English, so we get on very well together.
Bye-bye.
Almost immediately, Berhanu settles into the Nicol household and assumes the role of his son and brother. In just a few days, Berhanu has worked his way into the Nicol's hearts. Now it's time for the team at Children's Hospital to do their work on Berhanu.
Where did this come from?
At first sight, Dr. Skaggs realizes he has a life and death case on his hands.
I was a little bit shocked at how deformed he looked. I expected him to look twisted to the side, having scoliosis, but he was also humped forward a great deal. And that's the most dangerous thing for correcting spinal deformity. I was truly worried, can we make this child straight without paralyzing him?
But it's a risk they have to take. A series of tests and exams are done to make sure Berhanu can even survive the operation. First is an MRI.
Watching Berhanu going under anesthetic was pretty heartbreaking.
Generally speaking, he's the meekest little person on the face of the earth. So just a poor wee soul.
Next is an echocardiogram to make sure his heart is strong enough to endure hours of surgery. Meanwhile, the MRI scans come in for Dr. Skaggs' review. It is one of the most life-threatening cases he has ever seen.
At Children's Hospital Los Angeles, we see the most children with spinal problems of any place in the West Coast. And Berhanu stuck out as particularly bad. You know, maybe 9 on a scale of 1 to 10.
Next, Berhanu's back and hand are x-rayed. Dr. Skaggs stretches him out to test the stiffness of his spine. Because his spine barely moves, 2 operations will be needed to correct his scoliosis.
Okay, good job.
Dr. Andre Panosian, the plastic surgeon who will be operating on Berhanu's hand, studies the x-rays.
Right here, we're looking ahead at his right arm. We can see that there appears to be a thumb-shaped structure here, although he's missing the fingers in between. I think there's almost always something we can try to do to improve function, depending on how much of the function he's already actually got.
After consultations with the team of doctors, Berhanu gets the green light for surgery.
The corrective force is taking what's curved and pulling it over, and 2, attaching another rod that's not here at the top and bottom, and stretching. So you take what's curved and stretch it out. At most major medical centers in the United States, someone like Berhanu would have screws drilled into his head and literally pulled up with weights for weeks, if not months, to slowly straighten his spine. At Children's Hospital of Los Angeles, we've pioneered a technique where we don't put screws in the kid's head, and we're able to do everything from inside the body. And we're able to shorten this to 2 surgical procedures within a week.
Dr. Skaggs, who has a son the same age as Berhanu, makes a promise.
We'll tell him, and I'll treat him just like he was my son.
After years of severe scoliosis and only a week in the United States, Berhanu heads to surgery.
Malnourished. He's a setup for things going wrong, for getting an infection, for having problems. And I worry about it. We're taking a risk. So it's a big responsibility to make sure he comes out okay.
All on board?
Okay.
Dr. Skaggs and Dr. Colleen Sabatini screw 25 screws into the vertebrae. Rods are attached and tightened, slowly bending the spine back to its intended straight position. They cut fused bones and stretch Berhanu's back to the best of their ability. But they know that forcing a severely curved spine to be perfectly straight is dangerous. So after more than 3 hours of surgery, they decide to stop.
Thank you. Thanks. Sometimes when the spine straightens, it becomes paralyzed. His spine has been curved for years and years and years. If we, over the course of a few hours, just make it straight, sometimes it pulls the blood vessels and the spinal cord no longer has a blood supply and the child's paralyzed. That's our fear.
They will give his spine 1 week to adjust, then operate again. While Dr. Panosian steps in to close the incision, Dr. Skaggs updates Caroline on the surgery.
We're definitely gonna need a second half, just like we thought.
Right.
The only surprise I had is that his curve really is much stiffer than I thought.
But just moments later, a grave problem arises in the OR. Dr. Skaggs' fears have come true. In an instant, the signal from Berhanu's spine to his legs is lost. He faces paralysis if the signal is not regained within minutes. So Dr. Skaggs returns to the OR. Since paralysis is not uncommon with this type of surgery, he is prepared and knows exactly what to do. He unscrews just one screw, loosening 2 rods.
We'll see if it works.
Okay, signals are good.
Okay.
The pressure on Berhanu's spine is relieved, and the signals come back.
This is kind of living on the edge as much as it gets. I mean, that child was literally paralyzed a minute ago. And if we didn't come in and immediately release that, he probably would be permanently paralyzed.
When I see the flat line, my heart jumps.
We have good neuromonitoring here, good anesthesia. The child's lucky. He's certainly dodged a bullet.
Because of the advanced technology and the fast reaction time of the doctors, Berhanu is on the way to walking upright for the first time in his life.
He has undergone the first step of a very major surgical procedure, and he's understandably had some pain postoperatively, which we have been working very closely with our pain service to manage.
In just 1 week, Berhanu returns to the OR, where Dr. Skaggs finishes the procedure.
Very quickly, the body will be losing this new position. We have to move fast. That went great. I thought that the curve was so stiff that we weren't going to be able to have too much of an effect. But I was surprised. We got the spine pretty straight. I think I'll go so far as to say that if anybody sees him in the future, they'll never know he had a spine problem.
After 2 months of recovery time, Berhanu returns to the hospital, 4 inches taller.
What was interesting about Berhanu is he spoke almost no English. And after the second surgery, when he came back, all he could do is look at me and say, thank you, with his big eyes, thank you. We realized it was all worthwhile.
But before he can go home to Ethiopia, Berhanu braves the knife once more, this time for his hand. The goal is to give him a pinching function so he will have better use of his fingers. Hours later, Dr. Panosian finishes the complicated surgery.
Okay, very good. He's going to end up having some level of pinch, so I'm very happy.
Berhanu's series of operations is done.
Good one. So once we get out of the hospital after that, it was like, yes, we're finished.
And as he walked out of the hospital, it was day one of a brand new life.
In just a few weeks, he's putting his transformed body to the test.
If we did nothing, the amount that he could breathe would go down and down and down, and he probably would have died early. What we know we've done is we've opened up his lungs a bit, and we've prevented this from getting worse. So I think that we've bought him a full lifetime.
When he first came, there was no smiles. There was nothing in his eyes, and now you can see, you know, the life in his eyes, and the smiles.
What's going on here?
It's just like, you know what, he's just like an ordinary 8-year-old child. He's not like a child with no hope. There's hope there.
Berhanu, still an orphan, but no longer an outcast, can start a new chapter in his life.
Mending Kids International is as close as you could come to a guardian angel. They truly change kids' lives.
I call it a chaotic ballet. Because it really does, it's a lot of chaos and a lot of work and a lot of things to have this outcome that's just incredibly beautiful.
It just rains love in Children's Hospital. The doctors, whether it be Dr. Skaggs, Sabatini, they're just more than doctors, they're like angels.
To be able to be a part of, you know, helping to hopefully make his life better is really a privilege for me and I think all of us.
Dr. Skaggs was really excited about Berhanu. I mean, you know, you see the pictures, sort of the before and the after, and I'm not completely sure who's smiling bigger.
Just looking at his pictures before and after is all the reward I could ever ask for.
The Nichols enjoy the last few days they have with the child who's left a permanent mark on their hearts.
The thought of him leaving and no Berhanu running through this house, oh my goodness, you know, it's as if I'm losing, believe it or not, a child of my own.
A child who came with a life-threatening condition is mended and back on the road to a happier, healthier life.
He's going home with a mended spine, and he'll be able to run and jump, and he loves to jump. When we're walking down the street, we'll say, jump, 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 jump. And he jumps. And hopefully he's going to go home with a boldness. And he'll be able to look at people in the eye now and know that he's equal with them. And he doesn't need to shy away. And it'll take a part of us with him.
It's the beginning of a new, promising life for Berhanu, thanks to a loving couple, Mending Kids International, and the work of all the doctors and nurses who cared for him at Children's Hospital, Los Angeles.